How many units should I order for my first Amazon shipment? Hi, my name is Sumner Hobart, and in today's video, I'm gonna break down my exact step-by-step formula that you can use to calculate exactly how many units you should be ordering for your first shipment to Amazon FBA to where you're not ordering too many and getting hit with long-term storage fees, as well as not ordering too few and going out of stock and having to spend and waste a lot of money to re-rank your product. And I'll also explain what all that means and my reason for why the formula is the way that it is. Honestly, nothing too complicated, fairly simple, yet a couple things that are very important to keep in mind that a lot of new sellers completely ignore when ordering product for the first time. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the slides. So in order to know how many units we need to order for our first Amazon shipment, we need to understand demand. How many units do people actually want to buy? How many units are currently, our competitors currently selling on Amazon? And luckily this is very easy to do and it's fairly accurate. There's nothing that's ever going to be 100% accurate. Nobody can ever predict the future. And if they're telling you that, they're probably crazy, right? You shouldn't listen to them. But instead of, you could either guess and try to randomly come up with a number of, oh, I think I should order this many units, or you could rely on data. And I would recommend the latter of relying on data. And specifically, I'm going to show you briefly three tools that you can use that will show you the demand for certain products. And specifically, they'll show you sales estimates for your top competitors, in this case, your future competitors, right, that are selling very similar products. These tools will show you how many units per month these existing competitors are selling. So then you can kind of estimate demand, and I'll show you how to plug that into a very simple formula that we're gonna use in a second. So that's number one. Number two, the three tools I'm gonna share with you all have free trials, okay? So I'm not trying to push you to go pay for a tool, okay? You don't need to pay for something you don't need. What I highly recommend that you do is, number one, use a tool. Number two, use the free trial with each of these options, okay? To where this can be literally 100% free and very, very accurate, okay? Links to each of these tools that I'm about to cover really briefly are in the description section, so you can access them there. Again, you can use the link and then use the free trial. If you feel you want to pay, because there's a lot of other great functionality as well, that's completely up to you if you have other business purposes. But like I said, get started with a free trial. And the reason for using three tools instead of one, which we'll see in just a second, is because it's kind of like if you get diagnosed with something very, very critical and you go to one doctor and they diagnose you, you want to make sure that that doctor is right, okay? So you may get a second opinion or even a third opinion, right? It's kind of like they're also diversifying in the stock market. The more you diversify, the less risk you have of in case one stock underperforms. It's the same idea here. Using multiple tools reduces risk by increasing accuracy. And you'll see what I mean in a second. I know I kind of just vomited all this information on you at once, but the first tool here is called Helium 10. And specifically, this is the Helium 10 X-ray tool. Okay, so what you can do, click the link. You can sign up for a free account or just go type in Helium 10 into Google, sign up for a free account. Then what you want to do is download their free Google Chrome extension. I have a whole video on the Google Chrome extension, so I'll just kind of briefly cover it for those of you that aren't aware. Download the Chrome extension. With your free account, what you'll do is you'll go to Amazon.com and you'll type in your main product keywords. So let's say you're going to sell a pink silicone soap mold. Okay, that's the product you're going to sell on Amazon. You would type in pink soap mold or silicone soap mold or whatever your main keywords are, type those into Amazon, hit enter. You'll see a whole list of search results, all the different products that are currently being sold that relate to soap molds, right? All the different pink soap molds, and specifically the best selling, right? Because the first page are the best sellers, okay? So type in your keywords, you hit enter, go up to the top right-hand corner of your screen, click on the Helium 10 Chrome extension, then click on the X-ray tool. It'll just say X-ray, click on that, and you'll get to a, you'll be shown a graph that looks something very, very similar to this. And specifically, it looks kind of messy, it looks kind of crazy, but specifically what you want to look at is the middle column, or kind of the middle column here that says sales, okay? So look at the sales column here, that's what you're going to focus on. And essentially what Helium 10 has done, and other tools, a couple other tools that I'll show you in a second, that operate in almost the exact same way, what they do is they extract data and they estimate the monthly sales. So how many sales per month that each product on the first page of the search results are making. Okay, that's extremely valuable information to know, because if we can see, okay, our average, you know, top 5 to 10 competitors are selling about, you know, 300 units a month, okay, then we know we'll probably sell 300 a month, or that we'll need to sell 300 a month. And that's going to help you estimate how many units to order. There's a couple other variables you need to keep in mind, which I'll cover in a second. Again, nothing needs to be too complicated. At first, it seems a little bit overwhelming, but it's really not. So that's step one. Helium 10 free Chrome extension. Create a free account. Type in your main keywords into Amazon. Hit enter. Click on the Chrome extension. It'll show you the estimated sales data. And again, this is an estimate. There's no way that you're ever going to have exact 100% definitive sales data. But this estimate, these estimates are highly, highly accurate. And this part of the reason I'm recommending this tool is, number one, it's free trial. Number two, Helium 10 is very, very accurate overall. It's one of the most accurate that I have found personally. So it's really great data. However, it's still an estimate. So we want to get a kind of a second doctor's opinion. So what we're going to do is use also another tool and do the exact same process just to make sure that the numbers are similar. Because here's the thing, wouldn't this be interesting, is if you use one tool, right? And it shows, okay, on average, let's say the top 5 to 10 sellers are selling, you know, 300 units a month. And that's what Helium 10 said. But then you use another tool and it tells you it's 100. That's a really big difference. Okay. So what you want to do is use two or even three tools. Again, you can use the free trials and then estimate and take the average of all three, because that's going to be the most accurate and the closest to the real number that you can get to. And it's much better than just trying to guess on your own. So that's step number, so one is Helium 10. Tool number two that also has a free trial is Viral Launch, okay? Viral Launch, link is in the description. Exact same process, okay? You're gonna get a graph very similar to Helium 10. You're gonna scroll over, look at the sales column. Again, look at the sales column, and then you can organize from highest to lowest. And what that's gonna do is that's gonna show you the highest selling products to the lowest selling products. So you can see, you know, what the top sellers are doing and what the bottom sellers are doing, okay? So that's tool number two. Again, exact same process. Don't need to go through that again. Tool number three, again, very accurate. It has a really great free trial. Is called eGrow. Link is also in the description, of course. Same process. Look over in the sales column. You can organize from highest to lowest. So you can find ultimately what you want to look for. Use two or three of these tools, whichever one gets you, you know, the best free trial. I like to use three to have the most data possible. And what you're going to do is you're going to organize the list from highest to lowest, and you're going to look at what are the average sales of the top 5 sellers to the top 10 sellers. And these are obviously going to be your future competitors, right? But right now, the top 5 to 10 sellers in that category. So you type in your main keyword, look at what Helium 10 says the top 5 to 10 competitors are selling per month. Look at what Viral Launch says the top 5 to 10 sellers are selling per month, how many units they're selling per month. And then also eGrow. Top 5 to 10 sellers, how many units are they selling per month? Take the average of all three tools together. And what you'll do is you'll take that number, right? Whatever the average is, that's X units. Take that average, divide that by 30. That's going to give you your daily sales. Really, really simple formula, okay? Total units per month divided by 30, that's your average daily sales. That's your estimated daily sales. So I'll show you how this number plugs into our next equation. So this is one half of the equation. Now, there's the other half of the equation that most new sellers completely ignore or forget about, and it's very, very critical, okay? So, again, total, look at the estimates of the three of the tools combined. What are the top 5 to 10 sellers? How many units are they selling on average per month? Divide that by 30. So, how many are they selling in 30 days? Divide that by 30. Now, you have daily sales, the average number of sales per day. And specifically, you may be wondering, well, Sumner, Why look at the top 5 to 10 competitors? There's some other people on YouTube who tell me to look at the bottom of the first page, meaning what are some of the lower sellers making on the first page? Here's the thing to keep in mind. All right. If you want to start selling on Amazon and you want to be average, I would recommend not selling on Amazon. If you want to have an average business, don't go into business. If you ever want to sell online anything, always plan and have the mindset and have the strategy to be the best that you can be. Doesn't mean you're going to be perfect. So your goal should be, you know, not to look at what are the lower below average sellers making. You want to be an above average seller. You want to make above average profit. So you need to look at what the top sellers are making. Okay. So that's why specifically I tell you to look at the top 5 to 10 competitors. You can even look at the top 5, top 3 competitors, right? If you really want to get that accurate.
or that that high level. However, again, you want to have enough data to make an informed decision. So you don't want to just rely on two or three. You want to have at least five, and 10 will give you some better. But just keep in mind that you'll want to sell at least at that level or above that level. Okay. Ultimately, you know, if you don't want to win, then you're going to lose. So that's my reason for that. I think I touched on that enough. So that's my reason for that. Very simply, super easy to get your daily sales. Then with that data in mind and up to this point, step two is to calculate your lead time. If you do not know what lead time is, you should be thankful that you found this video. This is something that I find a lot of new sellers completely ignore, forget about, and I'm going to try to make this as simple as possible. Okay. Your lead time is basically how long it takes from when you call, let's just pretend you call up your supplier and say, hey, supplier, I want to place a brand new order of, you know, however many units, it doesn't matter. I want to place a new order of units. From the time that you make that call and you pay them, right? You pay them, the order starts, production starts, to the time that it's available for sale on Amazon. Okay, so when you say, hey, I want new products, to the time that it actually is available for sale on Amazon, that entire period, that's your lead time. That's how long it takes you, right? So that's very, very important to know. And it's very easy to calculate. So there's three main parts. You can include more parts here, but just keep it simple. There's three main parts. You have your production time, also known as your manufacturing time. This is how long it takes for your products to be produced, to be manufactured. Okay, so let's, for hypothetical reasons, let's say that's 30 days, which might be a little bit long. It depends on your product. Some products, this might be very, very short. For other products, this may seem very, very long. Okay, so this is just an example, but let's say production takes 30 days. It takes 30 days from the time that you call your supplier or you pay them money and say, hey, I would like a new order of this product. Boom. From that point, it takes 30 days for them to completely produce everything, your product. And by the way, in the production time, you'll want to also include the time it takes for inspection service. Again, that can kind of be included in production time, but always take into account inspection services. Just as a side note, always use an inspection service. I have a whole video on this, so I'm not going to go into detail about that. But the whole time it takes to manufacture, produce, and verify, you know, make sure everything's good to go. Then from there, how long does it take to ship products from your manufacturer, whether they're in China, Vietnam, whether they're in the United States, wherever they are, how long does it take to ship your products, your brand new products, from wherever they are into Amazon's FBA warehouse? And then also, this is what a lot of people miss, is how long does it take on average for Amazon to scan your units, okay? And I found that it takes, again, it definitely depends on the product, the time of year, all of that, but on average, it takes between 2 to 10 days for Amazon to scan your units. Meaning, so your units are produced, that's step one, great. Step two, they're shipped into Amazon's FBA warehouse. Okay, great. But guess what? They're shipped into Amazon's warehouse. Doesn't mean automatically they're magically ready for sale. Either a robot or a human being needs to scan them and put them, you know, put them in shelves or wherever, put them on a Roomba and make them ready for sale. Okay, and that takes a little bit of time. Again, it can take as little as 2 days, even less than 2 days. It can take up to 10 days. In some cases, it's actually taken longer in some weird circumstances. But on average, I found about 5 days for my own products. So again, that's something you want to take into account. If this is your first time, you want to kind of, you want to just pay attention. So for your first order, pay attention how long each of these take, right? And you can just estimate, you can say, okay, here's what I estimated for my first shipment, how long everything would take. And here's how long everything actually took. Okay, and it's good to kind of keep that in mind and see how close your forecasting is. Really simple. How long does it take to produce? How long does it take to ship? How long does it take to scan / stock your units into Amazon's warehouse? That you, when you add all of that together, that's your total lead time, which in this case would be 45 days because 30 plus 10 plus 5, right, is 45 days. Okay, you can pause, you can go back in case I went too fast, but it should be pretty straightforward. So that's your total lead time, okay? And I want to just kind of pause right here because this is very important. Here's a little hypothetical situation for you just to kind of get the wheels churning. Let's say, just to keep things simple, that you estimate, okay, we go all, you know, let's go all the way back, that you estimate your daily sales are going to be about one per day, right? That in order to compete with the top 5 to 10 competitors, you need to sell one unit a day, right? Okay. So, one unit a day. And let's say your lead time is 45 days. Okay, so your lead time is 45 days. On average, you're gonna sell one unit a day. Okay, great, we have that information, great. Done, next. Okay, next, for whatever reason, you just think, all right, I'm just going to order 45 units and see how this thing goes. I'm going to see how this Amazon FBA thing goes. You order 45 units. So those 45 units are being produced. They're being shipped to Amazon's warehouse. They get scanned. Boom, now they're ready for sale. Guess what that means? The day that you start selling products on Amazon, if your lead time is 45 days and you sell one unit a day, with that, and you have 45 units in stock, that means that the day that you start selling in this specific situation is the day that you have to place a reorder. So you have to reorder before you even sell one unit or in the first day that you start selling. And you may, this may kind of confuse you for a second, but just pause, go back, watch it again. I promise it takes a little bit of time to sink in. It's a little bit of a difficult concept to understand, which is why I want to just kind of pause and really focus on this. But again, just to briefly restate, if you sell on average, one unit a day and your lead time is 45 days, okay, that means, it takes 45 days for when you call your supplier for a new order to when it actually becomes available for sale. That's 45 days. And on average, you sell one a day, right? So that's one, right? That's the situation. And then for whatever reason, you order 45 units. I don't know why you only order 45, but let's just say you order 45 units. That means you have enough inventory for 45 days. 45 units at one unit a day, that's 45 days worth of inventory. Your days worth of inventory is 45. Your lead time is 45. They're equal to each other. So that means, okay, if you don't want to go out of stock, that you need to reorder on the same day that you start selling, okay? What a lot of sellers do, and they kind of get in this misconception is, so for example, let's say I ordered the 45 units. I'm selling, for 1 week, so that's 7 days. Another week, that's 14 days. Another week, right, 21 days, and so on. And then I get to day 45, and then I'm like, oh, wow, I'm starting to run out of inventory. I need to place a reorder. Well, guess what? Let's say it's day 45, and I've sold 45 units so far, and now I place a reorder. I didn't place a reorder before. Let's say in this situation, now I place a reorder. What does that mean? That means it's going to take 45 days from that day until I receive more inventory in Amazon's warehouse. It doesn't matter how many I order or whatever. It's going to take 45 days from that time, from right now, until I have more inventory in Amazon's warehouse. Okay? What does that mean? That means you're going to go 45 days without inventory. Okay? So if you wait until day 45 to reorder, that means you have another 45 days of no inventory. And that basically means you're out of stock, right? The people want to buy your product, but they can't because you don't have any products to sell, right? You're currently in the process of producing more. They're being shipped. They're being scanned, but they're not available for sale, okay? So what happens is when you run out of stock on Amazon, you may think, oh, it's my first shipment. I'm just going to order like a test amount. And if I go out of stock, it's fine. What happens is when you go out of stock, that sends negative signals to Amazon's algorithm. And Amazon actually there's evidence to suggest, I should say, that Amazon gives basically a grade to your Amazon seller account and specifically to your listing. And when you make money, Amazon makes money, right? Because if you're using Amazon's fulfillment services and you're using Amazon as a sales channel, you pay them a referral fee. So whenever you make a sale on Amazon, Amazon makes money. So when you make money, Amazon makes money. The reverse is also true. When you don't make money, Amazon doesn't make money, okay? So when you're out of stock, that means Amazon is missing, you're missing out on money, and so is Amazon. Amazon doesn't like missing out on money. So what does that mean? When you run out of stock, Amazon's gonna be like, this seller doesn't know how to stay in stock. This seller, we shouldn't invest as much of our resources or really help this seller with ranking, because if we help another seller rank that stays in stock all the time, we could potentially monetize or make more money because they're constantly in stock and we can make sales off of them, okay? That's kind of a way of simplifying it. It's not 100% like, fact from God that he gave this to us, but it's a fact that if you run out of stock, it's not a good thing. You may have to completely re-rank, completely relaunch, and you may not be able to get to the same point that you were before. So don't have the mindset of, oh, this is my first product. I'm just going to order a test order, see how it goes, and just kind of throw it up there. If you do that, I can almost guarantee you're going to fail, period. Do not have that mindset. Seriously. I've had that mindset. I've had a lot of difficulty from running out of stock, even when I really try to. So just not something to freak out about, but just something to keep in mind. And a little tip, when running out of stock, as soon as you go out of stock, make your listing inactive, Okay. So try to run out of stock for as little. So if you do run out of stock, try to have as few days as possible. The longer you're out of stock, the worse it is. The shorter you're out of stock, the better it is. There's been times where I've been out of stock for less than a week, or maybe even less than a little over a week. And I made my listing inactive as soon as I went out of stock, turned my listing back on right when my stock was back in inventory, and didn't really have any major issues. There's been times where I've been out of stock longer than 2 weeks. That actually happened, I think, only once. And I had to basically relaunch and re-rank, right? So I think I'm repeating myself because it's important. Don't run out of stock. Order enough units to where you have enough in inventory to where you have enough to not just last the lead time, but you need to order at least the lead time, if not more. Okay, so for example, in this case, my lead time is 45 days. That means that I need to order a lot more than 45 days worth of inventory. Okay, so that's kind of what this means. And I hope this makes sense. It's kind of a confusing concept. I almost didn't want to make a YouTube video about this because of how confusing it is. But that's also part of the reason that there's such little information about this. Okay, so I hope this makes sense. By the way, if you have any questions, let me know in the comments and I can give more detailed responses there. And you can join our AMZ Escape Plan Facebook group. Link is in the description. Free group, by the way. And you can ask more in-depth questions there and I can respond there. You can message me on social media as well. You know, literally, I'm here to help you. And I know this can be kind of a confusing topic. But again, number one, figure out your average daily sales. Number two, figure out your lead time. Number three, now you need to order more than your lead time because you don't want to run out of stock. Running out of stock is very bad. So you may be thinking, okay, well, I know my lead time now, Sumner. I know my average daily sales, or I know how to estimate my average daily sales. How many do I order? Isn't that the whole reason I watched this video? How many units do I order for my first Amazon shipment? It's ultimately up to you. Again, you want to order more than your lead time, so you have that. And just to give you some reference, on my product's average lead time, total lead time, is right around 30 days total for my specific products, okay? For my first-time shipments, for brand-new products, and for my existing products, I usually order around 2 months worth of inventory, meaning, again, I go back to that formula that we did here, okay? I look at how many daily sales, okay, on average are my competitors making. This is for first-time products. If I already have products that have been selling for a while, for a year, 2 years, or whatever, I can look at my historic data and make a better decision. But for my first-time order, which is the whole reason you watch this video, you have to kind of rely on tools or, you know, the best data that's available for your decisions. I figure out what the daily sales are. I multiply that by 60 because 30 days in a month, 30 times 2 is 60, right, for 2 months. So usually I order between 2 months. If my lead time was longer, more toward that 45 days, right? More toward that 45 day mark, then I might order 3 months worth of inventory. So basically 2 months worth of inventory, that means I have 60 days worth of inventory based on my estimation, based on how many units I think I'll sell per day, right? 2 months worth of inventory. If my lead time was longer, then I might order 3 months. Okay, that's my personal criteria to kind of help you. Again, there is no definitive like right answer of this is exactly the number. Like, there are people saying, oh, order 500 units or order, you know, exactly this many. If they're telling you that, ignore them, block them. They do not know what they're talking about. There is not a one-size-fits-all solution. Like, you know, humans are extremely diverse. Everyone's different. So are products and so are markets. It's extremely diverse. There are so many different products out there. But hopefully now you have the exact formulas, strategies, principles, everything that you need to easily and quickly and for free calculate how many units to order for your first Amazon shipment. Hopefully this was helpful. And lastly, as a special kind of offer for those of you who've kind of watched all the way through to the end, in the description section of this video, along with everything else, is a link to where you can get full access. I have an entire Alibaba to Amazon FBA course, which covers a lot more than just, it covers lead times and UPC codes and finding and partnering with suppliers and tips to get reduced rates, freight forwarders, and all that kind of information that seems really confusing. You can get access to this entire course on Skillshare for literally 100% free. So you can use the link below, click on that link, and you'll get a free 2 months to Skillshare if you don't already have a Skillshare plan, right? And then within that 2 months, as long as you watch the entire course within the 2 months, which is very easy to do, then you basically get entire access to the course for 100% free, literally. There's no catch, nothing like that. It's kind of how Skillshare works. So, and again, I'm all about sharing information for free or as as valuable as possible without, you know, scamming people. It's not what I'm about. So you can go ahead and check it out. No risk to you. Feel free to check it out. And lastly, if you like the video, let me know by giving me a thumbs up and leaving a comment below. Any questions that you have, anything that you want more clarification on, anything that you liked, let me know in the comments below. And be sure to subscribe to this channel because there are a lot of great videos just for you right here on the channel already, just like this one, and a lot more coming to you very, very soon. And I want to make sure you don't miss out. So be sure to like, comment, subscribe, check out the course. Like I said, you can literally get free access as long as you watch it within the 2-month period. It's a special promo that Skillshare is having, so I wanted to share that with you. And lastly, if you have any questions, be sure to let me know. As always, thank you so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you in future videos.